Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to ESW Raw. My name is Jesse Saint alongside Lewis, and oh my god, the first episode, I can't wait. Can you?
I cannot wait, and ALM is kicking off the show. Ladies and gentlemen, here we are, our first show following 200 degrees to get straight to business. There's a lot going on right now, so I want to say it now. So, you guys want the good or the bad first? Actually, I'll be the judge of that one. The good is that the ESW World Heavyweight Championship is currently vacated. That actually sounds pretty bad, but not for the guys in the back watching this right now. There'd been an announcement stating that it'd be claimed by a rightful champion at Slammathon 1. And we all know how far away that is. So maybe, just maybe, there could be some arrangements by the chairman himself, yours truly, standing in this ring, to make that happen sooner. But I don't know. I'll have to think about that one. But you guys need to stay tuned for what will happen with the vacancy of that title. One thing that will be happening in order to crown a new champion is a 10-man gauntlet match. This match will contain 10 hungry warriors that desire this title so very much. And two men will be fighting at a time, whereas a new opponent will enter the match if one of the two current men are eliminated by pinfall or submission. However, using weapons or outside interference will result in a disqualification for that fighter. But you want to know what really grinds my gears? That me, A.L.M., a man that had to stand against multiple forces at once since day one, numero uno. I can't even enter that match because of that one day where if I got pinned or submitted in that match against Tony Gibson, that I would be banned for going for any titles in this company, my company. Can you believe it? And the worst part is, the man that pinned me in that match isn't even here anymore. He's fired. He's fired, for crying out loud. Oh, wait a minute. Wait, whoa. Now that I realize he isn't here anymore, I just remembered there was a small print on the bottom of the contract, and it said, damn it, I forgot. I need to go get that contract from my office right now.
What?
What? Wait.
ALM could be onto something.
If he is, then... Hey.
Number one contenders match, though, tonight. And
Devine versus Ryan Riley.
Yep. And Jesse Smoke versus Shield is going to be happening right now. But, oh boy. ALM just announced a 10-man gauntlet match. And I cannot wait for that.
Neither can I, Lewis. Neither can I.
That is probably going to be the greatest match we ever had.
In ESW history?
Possibly. And I'm wondering what is actually on that contract, which is a small print on the bottom. I don't know. That could be something very, very important. And now I really want to know.
Same here.
We're going to be kicking off things here tonight with Shield and Jesse Smoke. And if you didn't watch 200 Degrees, which you should go watch. Well, we recently had Mr. K versus Jesse Smoke, but we all know how that ended in a disqualification because of this bright guy here, Shield. So now we're going to have Jesse Smoke versus Shield to settle things the right way.
And it better be settled the right way, or else, who knows, Shield and Mr. K could get fired by ALM.
Or Jesse could just, you know, beat both of them up.
Yeah, Smoke could just snap.
I mean, you gotta look at the past, though. ALM has been through this before with the Shield and Mr. K, but he's been able to overcome it. So hopefully Jesse Smoke can do the same thing.
And here comes Jesse Smoke. Looks like he's got a more serious attitude.
Yeah, I don't think he's too happy with how things ended, so yeah, he's going to probably be taking things more serious at this point.
Who knows, he could be in that 10-man gauntlet match for the ESW World Heavyweight Championship.
You're right about that one.
And so could Shield. Like, who knows?
As you may know, number one contenders match tonight, Ryan Riley and Devine, and I'm pretty sure that's a fair one for Riley because, as you know, he hasn't been given the right to a title match at 200 Degrees. It's been canceled because of the release of Tony Gibson, so hopefully Riley will defend his number one contenders match. Well,
Ryan Riley just deserves that number one contendership.
I mean, he's never gotten the title, he's never been able to fight for it because of Tony Gibson, so yeah.
But anyways, Shield taking advantage in this match, it looks like.
Oh, Shield's got Jesse Smoke pretty tight there. Oh, never mind, Jesse's gonna change things
Jesse
around.
Come back.
And it looks like we're just going back and forth here.
Back
just
and
about
forth
it.
We go. Like,
oh, elbow to Shield's face.
That was a nice elbow to the face.
And hopefully Mr. K is watching backstage and looking
at this.
Oh,
and an arm trap. STO. And now what's he thinking?
Oh
no.
Oh!
Fireman's carry gut buster.
I mean, you gotta look at it this way. Like, the Shield was a former champion. Oh, wait a minute! Knee to the face was that. Oh, he goes for the count.
Up one. Wait, was that a one?
Shield kicked out at one. But look at that replay, though. Looks like something you can use to break somebody's nose.
I know.
I mean, it looks like Shield has the upper hand in this one, though.
You know, if Shield can actually win this match and go on into that 10-man gauntlet match for the ESW Championship, then...
Well, he'd be a two-time champion there.
The first ever two-time champion.
Possibly, if he won the main event. Oh, jumping DDT!
That could be it! One, two,
oh, kick out!
No. Now what's he looking for?
Shield did have the opportunity to go for that ESW World Heavyweight Championship. I think it's time we change things around and give Jesse the chance. Hopefully He does prove himself.
Jesse Smokes actually had a chance for the Universal title, but we all know how that turned out.
And hopefully if he settled things right here, right now, then he can move on.
He could get a world championship shot.
Exactly. He could move on to bigger and better things. Oh, no. What's Smoke going for?
Oh, wait a minute. Oh, what?
Whoa!
Whoa, no. You gotta be kidding me!
I don't think I've even seen Smoke do that ever.
No, never. I didn't know he was that athletic. I mean, sure, he was athletic, but damn.
Well, now you know Smoke is looking to improve himself just by doing that and taking things further. And now he's on the top rope.
Top rope.
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Steel! Fuck! Come out of absolutely nowhere!
Wait, oh, no, this is over. It's over.
What? Whoa!
How was that? Can I get a replay on how he kicked out of that?
Look at this. Jesse Smoke just goes to the top rope and gets caught.
Boom! How can one even kick out of that? I think he pretty much swallowed that punch right there. Unbelievable. He got his shoulders up. Well, oh no, you gotta be kidding me. No.
And
now the bell has been rung. Disqualification. Looks like this is nowhere near over. Oh man, this is unbelievable.
You've just gotta be kidding me. How long is this gonna be going on for?
Looks like Mr. K has no remorse for Jesse, and he's just gonna keep continuing until he has his end of the bargain.
Looks like
I hear Opposed's music.
Wait a minute.
What's Opposed to? What? Where is he at?
Where? What?
Oh, what's he doing?
Oh, there he is. Oh, looks like Smoke has some backup. And look at this. Oh, something new.
Ooh. Unbelievable. That's what we need. Some backup for Jesse Smoke. We need to end this quick. This little thing that Smoke and Anarchus have right now, it cannot keep on like this. But still, we have later tonight that number one contenders match.
Ryan Riley versus Devine. I can't wait for that match, Lewis. Can you?
I cannot wait. Hopefully, Riley wins that match because, you know, he this company owes him a championship match.
Oh! Look who it is!
We haven't seen this guy in a while. And he's back! J-Train
is back.
And he's back in some brand new gear.
Brand new gear, but I wonder who he's going to be fighting.
And as you guys know, Slammathon 1 is coming up, so if you subscribe to us, you'll be able to watch our first ever pay-per-view live. We'll be making some history here on this channel, folks.
And it's going to be awesome. Still, I wonder who J-Train's opponent is tonight.
We're about to find out right now. Oh no, I hear that music from anywhere. What? You gotta be kidding.
I know this guy's name now.
Albano.
I knew it.
One half of world domination, the number one contender for the tag titles. Oh my goodness.
Benito.
And they've won at 200 degrees, earning that number one contendership by I believe it was a count out or whatever.
I think it was a disqualification.
And now they're the number one contenders. I don't know how. You'd have to ask Fusion on that one.
Yeah, ask Fusion and World Domination. I wouldn't want to ask World Domination. I'd ask Fusion.
Albano looking confident. Oh, what was he going for?
I have no idea, but J-Train just stopped him dead in his tracks.
A third attempt. Oh, Samoan drop.
Oh, massive Samoan drop there by J-Train.
I think Albano was actually trying to knock this man down, realizing how big he is.
Man! Oh, the strength.
I mean, you gotta think smart when you're fighting a big dude like this guy.
Exactly. Like, J-Train ain't no slouch. He knows what he's doing. And quite frankly, I think Albano knows what he's doing too.
Hopefully. Well, he didn't know it looks like he wasn't actually realizing what he was doing in 200 degrees, but hopefully he knows what he's doing right now. Actually, look at that. J-Train's just pushing off Albano like he's nothing.
Yeah, because J-Train is a pretty big guy. Oh, what's he got in store here?
Oh!
What's he got in store now? Ooh!
I would not want to be Albano right now.
Neither would I. Actually, I wouldn't want to be Albano at any time, to be honest.
Oh, no! Albano looking to turn the tables here.
Albano! Oh, nice neckbreaker by Albano.
Imagine if J-Train were in the 10-man gauntlet match. That would be some serious stuff right there, because this big guy, who could even take him?
If he was in the gauntlet match, we'd be looking at the ESW champion right here, right now.
Oh, going for the count. Nope. J-Train kicks out.
J-Train powers out.
He's looking real confident right now.
Imagine Albano or Benito in the gauntlet match. Now that would just...
Oh, no. I would not... No, I just wouldn't even take that seriously.
They'd probably get eliminated quick, in my opinion. Oh, and Albano with a nice knee to the face.
I'm surprised Albano's even taking some charge in this match.
Well, you never know, because World Domination was pretty dominant in the tag team match against Fusion. So.
Oh, J-Train looking to come back here. Oh! A punch that could break anyone's face. And goes for the count. Oh, kick out.
And a kick out by Albano. I don't know how he did that. Now what's he got in store? Oh, was that a neck breaker or a back breaker? I don't know.
Whatever it is, I wouldn't want to be hit by that guy. Oh no, what is this?
No. Oh god.
And nearly wanted to kill the man with... Oh my goodness.
I think he calls that the train crash, I don't know.
Oh no.
And a kick out by Albano.
Don't know how he's doing it, but he is doing it. What will it take for one of these men to even win this match? I don't know.
Yo, I'm just gonna say it right now. Albano is extremely resilient.
Oh, wait a minute! He got the big man on his shoulders!
How does he... Wait.
Oh! How is that even possible?
How was that possible?
Now he's going on the top rope.
Albano at the top rope.
Oh!
Is that a headbutt?
I believe so.
Oh, he could put him away here. You've got to be kidding
me. Come on, count faster. And now Albano's frustrated, telling the ref to count faster.
Oh. That had to hurt.
My. Albano is just doing great without his tag partner, Benito.
Imagine Benito in action. Well, on his own, of course.
Uh-oh.
What's J Train got in store now?
Oh.
Kick to the midsection. Pop up.
Oh.
Last ride.
And that's the end of Albano. Just like that.
J Train is back.
And better than ever.
Agreed.
Well, that was an impressive debut to Raw. And I gotta say, if this man does enter the 10-man gauntlet match,
well,
whoever he may be in the ring with, they better pray. And up next, we finally are moving on to the number one contenders match, Devine and Riley. Will Riley successfully retain his number one contendership? We shall find out.
Or will Devine become the next number one contender? Because remember, he's got James Icon by his side. And he did have Anthony Moore by his side a little bit, but we all know how that turned out.
Well, I think Icon is pretty much broken in half after what happened with ALM putting him away in that Flaming Tables match. Now it seems Devine is all by himself. And you know, Anthony Moore is more on ALM's side than James Icon, because you know what happened with that air quote plan B that ALM had.
And that was just, I was blown away. I didn't expect to see Anthony Moore in ESW.
I didn't even expect this man to be the third member. And to even backstab James Icon. Now, Riley looking to defend his number one contendership here in ESW. Who knows, we could be looking at our next ESW champion here. If he wins his number one contenders match, he will be in the main event of Slammathon.
And then whoever wins the gauntlet match
will be facing Ryan Riley for that title.
I don't even know who all of the participants are in the gauntlet match, but if J Train's gonna be in the match, yeah, he's my pick. But oh, look at this.
Starting things off a little dirty here.
Which man's gonna take the upper hand? Will it be Ryan Riley or Devine? And it looks like it's gonna be Ryan Riley.
Indeed. Oh, going for the pin early. Wow, Devine looks like he was almost going to get taken out so early in the match with that kick out at 2.
That was going to be it.
And now Devine's got Riley in the corner.
Devine looking to take advantage.
Oh, whatever he was going for failed, and now Riley has the upper hand again. Oh, knee to the face. Yeah, it looks like people are looking to break noses here, make an impression on Raw.
Broken noses, black eyes, it doesn't matter. Take a knee to the face like that, yeah, your face is gonna get messed up.
And you, not only will you be looking at your next future career plans, but you'll be looking at your hospital bill. Oh, Devine looking to go for a suplex, but he failed at it.
But Ryan Riley now.
I wonder how Devine is feeling right now by what happened at 200 Degrees. His own partner in Twisted Society just backstabbing him.
Yeah, alongside Savage and...
I can't even believe it. Like, he must be confused right now as to what has happened to Twisted Society, as it just crumbled to pieces right then and there.
The whole entire team has crumbled except for, well... Yeah, Devine and James Icon. Well, James Icon is probably in the freaking hospital right now.
And now Devine's all by himself.
Let's see how he can do on his own.
Oh, man.
Oh, that could be it. Ryan Riley into the pin.
Nope.
No.
And kick to the face will not do it. Oh no, what is this? Ooh! And now Riley.
That could be it.
Could be gone in a way. Nope. And I guess Devine ain't looking to finish this match just yet. What's he going for here?
Oh, reversal.
I gotta say, Riley's been doing pretty good by himself without, you know, his partner Gibson.
Both of these men are doing good on their own.
Yeah, that goes to show that they don't really have to depend on a stable to actually do well.
Yeah, Devine doesn't have to depend on Twisted Society, and Ryan Riley doesn't have to depend on Decimators.
Oh!
Ryan Riley with a beautiful move there. That could be it.
It's over. No! Kick out at 2.9.
How did he manage to kick out of that?
Two brilliant talents that... Either way, I would like to see any of these guys in the main event for the ESW Championship. Because, let's just face it here. These guys are good.
Imagine a rematch between these two at Slammathon.
Exactly. Unfortunately, I think it's only going to be one of them. And now Devine making a comeback here.
Devine looking to go to the top rope.
Oh,
a big splash.
That could be it. Oh, no.
Nice kick out. What a match this has been so far. And Ryan Riley with those knees again.
Now what's Riley going for? Oh! Another one on. And I think he's looking to put him away just right now. This could be it. Oh no, wait a minute! Out of nowhere with a powerbomb from Devine.
How did he manage to come back from that into a powerbomb? That was just... Oh. Nice move.
Riley looks like he's out of luck right now.
Man, if we see this match in the future one more time, because this is awesome so far.
I actually wouldn't mind seeing this match again.
Oh! Ooh.
Devine looked like he was going to go for something, but no. Plans were canceled by Riley's clothesline.
And uh-oh.
Oh, Famouser! Is that going to do it?
Is that going to be it? One, two,
and that's
three.
It.
That's it.
Riley successfully retains his number one contendership.
Off of a Famouser. Now, that was just unexpected.
Looks like he has something new in his arsenal, and it actually worked. I'm impressed.
Hey guys, I found the contract. It says, therefore, if Tony Gibson decides to leave the company, this contract shall be obsolete, and ALM will be re-granted access to all championships. I guess there was a brighter side after all.
Oh! What's ALM doing?
What is...
ALM just announced that he's been re-granted a world championship. Oh, first
and
aid kick!
And a first aid kick to Ryan Riley. What is going on?
ALM just announces he's been granted a world championship now, and I guess now he's going for Riley, who's the winner, and will be main eventing Slammathon. I am shocked.
That is a major shock. Like, I wasn't expecting that.